Well, that's scary. And that. I'm getting scared of that. My name is Dr. Courtney Tracy, and today we're going to be watching Fear Street 1994.
Hello?
Still alive.
Who is this?
It's happening again.
Primarily, we get scared because we want to survive. Fear and phobias are two different things. We can be afraid of something, and once that fear becomes excessive, then it can become a phobia. What a phobia consists of is excessive, unreasonable fear towards an object or a situation. You experience that excessive anxiety. You avoid the objects and the situations, and the level of anxiety and fear that you experience as a result is causing impairments in your life.
Shadyside, a history of horror, has earned it the nickname Killer Capital USA.
Throughout most of the experiences in our own lives, we can pretty much figure out why people do most of the things that they do, with the exception of serial killers. Diving into the mind of serial killers, it gives us an opportunity to have control over something that's so clearly out of control, and it gives us insight into something that we personally would never do or experience, and so we want to know why. Like, I don't want that thing running towards me.
What's going on?
I'm not doing this alone.
I can feel my adrenaline coming. The fact that I'm experiencing this rush of adrenaline watching these clips is indicative of just the human being response to watching something that's scary. It's sort of like why people go on roller coasters, because you get kind of that adrenaline. And I think that some people can like the adrenaline if they don't usually already have stress and anxiety and fear in their life. But I think that movies like this, for people that have severe anxiety or have phobias or have other fears, can have a negative reaction to this adrenaline. So I think it's important when watching films of this nature to check in with yourself and realize that you may see something that's going to cause a spike in your fight or flight response and to be prepared for that. Hiding under the blanket, definitely into just having this conversation.
This isn't yours, Dillweed.
Oh, I get it. You building a shrine or something?
All right, you know what? It's time for school. Get in the car.
All right, just let me finish up the stretch.
Yeah.
Dana, be careful with that!
I thought Dad said you weren't allowed on this anymore. Do you know how expensive AOL is?
I'm stealing it from the net. I'm talking to someone
online. This internet bullshit is potentially exactly why you have no friends.
It's not bullshit. It's a community dedicated to the truth. Look, some guy went crazy and killed a bunch of people at the mall last night.
The first thing that I noticed was their conversation started with her trying to get him to school and him saying that he basically didn't want to go to school because he was too concerned about what he was obsessing over. That's one of the main criteria for a diagnosis, is it getting in the way of work, school, or your relationships?
We should not be this close to the police station if we're in a stolen ambulance.
Well, that's the whole point. We're hiding in plain sight.
Yeah, just like Bundy.
That's true.
Ted Bundy, when he was stalking his victims, I mean.
But he got caught by his girlfriend.
So why do you know so much about killers?
Know thy enemy, right?
Exactly. He was not wrong just there, talking about how Ted Bundy hid in plain sight. And I also think that he was really accurate about know thy enemy, because that really is one of the main reasons that people are so obsessed with serial killers. Because we want to know, one, why, but also we want to know, how the hell do we avoid this person? And what are the signs so that we can know if their behavior is indicating that we're not okay?
78, 16.
You can tell he's really excited to like share all this information.
Psycho murders a bunch of kids at camp.
Nightwing.
I think it's really interesting that the youth in the film are the ones that are interested in figuring out how people can survive in this town. And now they're all probably going to be really thankful that he spent so much time underneath that blanket studying stuff. There are many different ways to treat phobias. You can treat it by something called systematic desensitization, which is where you slowly expose yourself to the object or the situation. There's also a more controversial aspect of resolving phobias, which is something called flooding. That is where you just really overwhelm the person with what it is that they're afraid of. And that's not my first go-to for sure. I do feel like it deserves the name Fear Street. I actually really want to watch the films. I like the fact that they're not just doing it because it's interesting. They're also doing it because they want to figure out how to make it not keep happening. My name is Dr. Courtney Tracy, and thanks for watching.